બેસો ને પરિચય આપો તમારો.
સર માય કોડ ઇઝ
40.
I have done my graduation in integrated law from Gujarat National Law University in the year 2020. During my years in the college, I was a part of several committees such as Legal Service Committee.
Okay.
So under that committee, we undertook several projects such as Legal Aid Clinic, Legal Awareness Workshops. We also assisted government in the project for the implementation of Dowry Prohibition Act. Apart from that, I was also a part of Sexual Harassment Grievance Redressal Committee of the University.
Mm-hmm.
And from the year 2020, I am preparing for civil services, and this is my first attempt.
Okay. Okay. UPSC appeared them?
No, sir. I haven't appeared in UPSC yet.
It seems law graduates are very power hungry. You know, they want to go into politics. They want to come into bureaucracy. You know, they want to rule.
Sir, I think the law, during the study of law, you received exposure to diverse fields of knowledge and diverse fields of working. So I think that is the reason they have basic aptitude to work for any field, and just after the years they achieve the excellence too.
So do you agree that they are power hungry?
Sir, I don't think they are power hungry. Sir, I don't think they are power hungry, but they definitely has a stake in various other fields too.
So how many students are part of the campus?
Sir, my campus consists of 1,000 undergraduate students and 200 postgraduate. That is
what is ranking, NIRF ki ranking mein NLU Gandhinagar kahan stand
karta hai? Sir, in NIRF, I am not aware about that. Thank you.
You are member of Sexual Harassment Committee.
Yes, sir.
What kind of complaints you have received over 1 year? Or you were part of integrated program?
Yes, sir.
So how many years you spent?
5 years.
5 years.
Yes, sir.
So kitne is tarike ke cases aapke paas hai sexual harassment?
Sir, we change the member changes each year. So I was a part during my third year.
Huh.
And during third year we received one complaint. However, that complaint has been disposed of because we didn't found corroborated evidences to assure that actually sexual harassment has been committed or not.
How did you investigate such matters?
Sir, so can I explain in detail?
Yes.
The case? So the girl has filed a complaint that while working in the one of the committee's room, the boy has came and started to grope her waist. And she also claimed that the similar scenario continues during their stay in the lift from third floor to ground floor. However, after the examining the full complaint, and we tried to corroborate it with the CCTV camera, but we didn't find anything unusual going on in CCTV camera.
So the girl and the boy were together during that period. Whenever she mentioned about the incident,
so both went together in the lift, and they came out together from the lift. But we didn't find the exact and clear evidences.
So lift had cameras?
No, sir. She mentioned that the similar incident continues to take place from the gate of the room up to the lift and in the lift also. But we didn't find the express evidences that
maybe she was in shock or she couldn't explain everything into the sequence it happened. It happened in such cases.
Yes, sir, definitely. The shock is a factor that always we took care of while invested getting such a complaint. So, however, we even given her a chance to re-examine her testimony also.
Mm-hmm.
But she was found that the similar incident only has taken place. So, eventually, we have to dispose of the complaint.
Did you question the guy also?
Yes, we questioned the guy also, sir.
And what was his version?
Sir, his version was not matching with the girl's version, and both have a contentious effects. So eventually we have to, since there was no clear evidences, we have to dispose of the complaint.
What do you feel personally, forget about being part of sexual harassment committee, suppose you are a close friend of her, maybe you are a brother, what you feel? Justice was done to her, or the people prefer to ignore under investigation karke matter ko close kiya?
Sir, we have to go by the fact. We can't judge such cases through trial by media.
Sir is asking what is your
personal. Suppose you are her brother.
Suppose.
Or a close friend.
Yes, sir.
And you feel कि justice हुआ या नहीं हुआ?
अगर आपकी बहन होती तो आप क्या करते?
Sir, I think justice has been served because there may be some other incidences that we didn't know of. However, it was certainly not the case of sexual harassment.
Okay. Okay.
So, my preference kya hai guys?
Sir, my first preference is Gujarat Administrative Service, then Deputy SP, then District Registrar and Assistant Commissioner of GST.
Okay. Okay. तो तुमने डोमा केम तुम्हारे नहीं बनाओ करियर एनी रीजन
सर सो व्हाइल वर्किंग इन द यूनिवर्सिटी ऑल दीज प्रोजेक्ट्स आई बिलीव दैट लॉ गिव मी अ स्पेसिफिक एक्सपीरियंसेस एंड स्पेसिफिक एक्सपोजर विच लिमिटेड टू लीगल फील्ड और जुडिशियल फील्ड वेयर एज सेम इज नॉट द केस विद एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव सर्विसेज एंड इट विल प्रोवाइड्स अ डाइवर्स फील्ड्स ऑफ एक्सपीरियंसेस
I read two books related to legal, you know.
Yes, sir.
Cases which changed India.
Yes, sir.
And cases which India forgot.
Yes, sir.
So I will come to the second book.
Yes, sir.
Can you mention a few of the cases which you mentioned there?
Yes, sir. So, sir, I think the late, from the independence or just the latest case?
No. Have you read these two books? Cases which changed India.
I think the cases that change India are referring to Zia Modi's
book. Yes, and then there is another book by Mr. Chandrachud.
Yes, sir.
Cases India Forgot.
Sir, I haven't read the Cases India Forgot, but I have gone through the summary of cases that changed the India.
Okay, so what are the cases mentioned?
Sir, the book mentioned the Indira Savani judgment.
Okay.
It has also mention of Keshavanand Bharti.
Okay.
It has also mention of ADM Jabalpur case.
Okay.
Sir, right now I am able
Mathura
to...
Mathura Das?
Yes, it was, there was a Mathura Das
what
case.
What is Mathura Das case?
Sir, Mathura Das case referred to, was regarding a rape allegation.
Mm-hmm.
And it is the case that has changed the onus, the burden of proof from the girl to and shifted to the shoulder of boys.
हिस्ट्री लगता है तुमने प्रश्न पूछू तो पहले तो तुम्हें जीपीएससी आपको जो यूपीएससी केम नहीं आता मतलब तुम्हें आपना नहीं फ्यूचर में
सर आई हैवंट मेड माय माइंड येट बट इफ आई गॉट अ चांस आई विल श्योरली गो फॉर यूपीएससी
टू सिलेबस सेम है तुम केम नहीं है
सर आई विल अपीयर नेक्स्ट ईयर बट राइट नाउ आई एम नॉट कंसीडरिंग द यूपीएससी
तुमने तो जम्मू कश्मीर में आईएएस बनावे
यस
और ये जीएएस बनावे तो तुम्हें कोई प्रेफर कर सो
Sir, I will prefer work in Gujarat as a GIS rather than going to Kashmir as IAS.
Kem yu matlab IAS to upar se tumhara candidately hire kar de
Sir, being a Gujarati and if I get a chance to serve the people of my state only, then I feel privileged to
regionalism
तो कश्मीर में कौन जैसे जो बधाई उपचार
सर इट इज नॉट अ रीजनलिज्म बट आई थिंक इट इज अ स्पिरिट ऑफ बीइंग अ गुजराती दैट हैज मोटिवेटेड मी टू गो फॉर
दैट इज सब
नेशनलिज्म
सर इट इज आल्सो आई डोंट थिंक इट इज अ सब नेशनलिज्म टू बिकॉज इफ आई विल गेट अ चांस टू सर्व इन जम्मू कश्मीर आई हैव नो इश्यूज विद हिम हाउएवर My primary choice will be to serve the Gujarat.
Now imagine most of the bureaucrats, top bureaucrats here, you know,
yes,
UPSC cadre,
yes,
IAS, IPS,
yes, sir.
Most of them, they come from different states. It can be north, it can be coming from Tamil Nadu. If they decide that they are not willing to go out and serve, you would not have the best of the officials.
Sir.
Especially if you talk about Gujarat.
Yes, sir.
You log nahi honge.
Yes, sir. So, we have the Gujarati officers too in the state services who are equally doing the good. So we can see that many GS officers during the time of COVID and other crises has done tremendously. And so it is not the case that if they decided not to come in other state, state will has a deviation for the officer.
ठीक छे. Act अने code वच्चे नो difference शू छे? कोई idea छे?
Sir, code is a vast legal context. Like if you refer to criminal Indian penal code. So it consists of many offenses and list of many crimes that can be committed and essences that are essential for the commission of crime. Our act is regarding a specific act, like dowry prohibition act. So it specifically deals with the dowry cases only. However, code deals with a vast amount of stuff.
Okay, Gujarat mein tourism develop karvu chhe, barobar chhe.
Yes sir.
To tron unique idea tame aapo ke jena thi tourism na development ne boost model.
Sir, the first thing I believe is we have a vast coastline. So first we have to focus. Just one example is recently declared Sivarajpur beach. In the time of few years, it has achieved a very good status and it is a very likable destination for the tourist.
What should you do? Means, koi unique idea tumhe aapko kya kya matlab kahi dete hain promote kar sakte?
Sir, we have to identify such beaches and also beach with natural sports like surfing. So Sri Lanka has developed this. They find various beaches with geographically diverse coastlines which are suitable for surfing and other natural sports. So we can also do the same. Another idea is we can also promote medical tourism. However, our government's policy is best suited to medical tourism, but we can give further boost to it.
सर आई एम नॉट एबल टू रिकॉल ओके मुश्किल लगता तुमने सवाल पूछो कि मुगल एम्पायर था एना पछी तुमने लगे मतलब छेले ब्रिटिशर्स इंडिया में आया ने रूल कर तो कोई मराठा एम्पायर तुमने वो लगे छे कि ये मुगल ने इनके एमना पछी एमना सक्सेशन में मराठा एम्पायर जो इंडिया में एस्टैब्लिश था तो ऑल ओवर इंडिया में बराबर तो मतलब अपनी कंट्री जी हालत में है ना ये हालत में हो सकती थी कि कई रीते शू थी सकत मतलब का तो मुगल कंटिन्यू रहा होता हूँ इनको जो ब्रिटिशर्स ना आया होता का तो मुगल कंटिन्यू रहा होता का तो मराठा एमने सक्सेड कर मुगल ने तो शू कई रीते सिचुएशन होती है कंट्री आने
सर कैन आई गेट अ फ्यू सेकंड्स टू थिंक So, sir, I think there may not be too much changes as far as the policies of the Mughals or Marathas are concerned. Mm-hmm. But however, we can see the rise of sub-nationalism or nationalistic pride during the going forward of the Marathas. So that may have religious factor may have played some role in succession of Marathas to the Mughals.
Mm-hmm. But hardly situation ma difference hoto apne desh aap condition ma hoto.
Sir, the progress we have achieved is through the democracy. It has not been achieved through any monarchs or any autocratic rulers. So I believe it is the democracy which has.
So you believe that the Britishers, am India mate aaya to overall maina gair fayda ghana hata. But fayda vadhare chhe ki gair fayda vadhare chhe. Tame kahi baju
vicharo. Sir, if you expressly ask me that, then it is more loss to us rather than a gain.
More lost to us.
Yes.
કેમ એવું તમને લાગે છે ડેમોક્રેસી આપી તમને ઇન્સ્ટિટ્યુશન્સ આપી આટલી બધી આખી એસ્ટેબ્લિશમેન્ટ ઓડો
મોડી અત્યારે હજી પણ રજવાડા જો તને તલવાર લઈને ઘોડા પર
ફરતા ઝઘડા ચાલતા હોતા ઈ
ચાલતું સર ડેમોક્રેસી ઇઝ નોટ સોલ ગિફ્ટ ઓફ બ્રિટિશર્સ અવર કોન્સ્ટિટ્યુશન એન્ડ ડેમોક્રેટિક આઈડિયાઝ આર બેઝ્ડ ઇન વેરિયસ સોર્સિસ એ
તો ઉભાસ થયા હતા અંગ્રેજો ને
So we have to give the credit of unification of the country as far as administrative or as far as governance policies are concerned to the Britishers. However, their policies like economic exploitation, those things has
kiche bhi paid the price you theek hai na mate but overall tumne shu lage benefit che ne are na ho to
atyare je apne pase liberty che ek citizen jod je liberty
atla even hu tum ko chu ki koi avado mota koi samrajya bhi hata ema maratha bhi atla class ke andar nata even mughals bhi nata to tumne એને ભી મતલબ ડિક્લાઇન થઈ ગયું તો પછી એટલું કદાચ દેશ આટલો હોતો બી નહીં ને ટુકડા હોતા તો તમને લાગે છે કે
Sir, so as sir said, liberty, democracy thing. So in the countries without the Britishers who has ruled in past also has a similar concept. And in India, our Hindu religion also believed in liberty and freedom to the other religions. So I don't think Britishers has very huge contribution as far as the democracy and liberty is concerned. We already has those tradition in our older times too.
Okay.
You said Britishers unified India.
Yes, sir.
But you know, they divided India, Pakistan, Bangladesh.
Sir, they have united India in terms of administrative policies. They have united India in terms of development of infrastructures. However, the division of Pakistan or Myanmar and Bangladesh are Sri Lanka are concerned. Those were the policies definitely dangerous to the unit.
What are differences between Eastern philosophies and Western philosophies?
Sir, I am not aware of
culture, religion. What are difference between Indian-based or Eastern-based religions,
sir,
and West?
Abrahamic religion difference, yeah, between Abrahamic religion and Hinduism,
yeah.
So, sir, if I allowed to take a guess,
yeah,
then I believe that Western philosophy is more believes in liberty and democratic thoughts. Though even we have a similar thoughts, but however we believe in culture, family values, and our societal values more than the individual liberty.
Only Abrahamic religion ma me ho jo ke generally expansion karwana normal ho hai conversion ke liye, sir. Ye difference?
Sir, yes, definitely. Hinduism doesn't believe in missionary activities and proselyte.
Abrahamic religion ma badha religion hai.
No, sir. I think Protestant doesn't follow the same ethos. It is belong to Catholics.
But Catholics,
and then trijogo religion, karo je Christian and Islam. Trijogo karo Abrahamic religion. Kya kya religion?
I think Jews also belong to Abrahamic religion.
Exactly. And
they don't believe in conversion. Yes, sir.
So do you think that ke matlab India ma je Muslims population atli badhi che conversion matlab forceful conversion to ke su lage che tamne?
Sir, it was not the case of forceful conversion. They have a different demographic profiles than we Hindus and other religion have, but definitely not a sole cause of conversion.
How about uniform civil code?
Sir, I believe the UCC is neither desirable nor achievable right now, and government and other stakeholders should nudge to adopt the UCC rather than imposing on any religion right now.
Why it is not desirable or needed?
Because sir, there is a, if we fail to nudge or persuade the other religions about the benefits of the UCC, then it may create havoc in the society and may bifurcate the more widen the difference between the religions.
It is bringing everyone on the same platform.
But sir, I am telling about extending for some period, and first we have to nudge or make them understand about the intentions.
Do you think constitution and a nation can function with multiple ways of governance? Tomorrow Muslim says like, okay, they want to bring Islamic banking, Sharia into their life. They won't display this is halal shop, this is not halal shop. Don't you think these would create lots of friction within the society?
Then it was to make dharma nu develop up jaru
sir. So our so our constitution has been functioning with differences since last 70 years. So however the differences which will result in a conflict should be avoided, and it has to be resolved even if the government has to take a strict actions against them. But otherwise our constitution following the unity in differences since a very long time, and it will continue.
Do you think conversion should be completely banned irrespective of what religion?
Sir, conversion through treachery or any hidden motive should be definitely be banned. However, if a person voluntarily wants to convert, then it should not be banned.
How to prove it?
Sir,
can you 100% be sure about it that a person is voluntarily
converting? Thing, you know, religion, Western religion says there is no son of God other than Jesus. There is no God other than Allah. And then they say, you know, if anyone questions our religion, yes, they should be punished. We believe Charvak, we believe in Advait, we believe in Buddhism, we believe in Jainism. and we believe all of them are part of us.
Yes.
They have a shape, they don't have a shape. So do you think this philosophy and this philosophy can coexist?
Yes, sir, surely it can coexist. However, we should not allow the differences to result in a conflict. That care has to be taken from all the religions to avoid such a chaos.